For me, I dread reading. I'm not good at it, or I'm not comfortable doing it. I think that I'm not a natural reader. There are those writers who just sound like amazing when they read, as if it was meant to be read. Poets often have that gift. Unfortunately, there have been one or two writers who I really admire, whose work I really admire, who I've been, sadly, I've actually seen them read, and their voices just didn't do justice to their work. And now whenever I read that work and those specific lines that they read aloud, I can't get their voices out of my head. It can be a real distraction. I'm good at talking. I like the back and forth that can be had in a good conversation. Playing the part of a writer is a bit of performance, and that's part of the gig, is you read and you pontificate. I think also reading is as close to being a musician or performer that it's as close as a writer can get. There's a lot of theatrics that goes into this, and reading is one of those things. And there are people who really want to hear the voice of the person who created the thing. I don't want to hear the voice of the person who's written a book that I really love. I like my imagination's relationship with that book. My hope is when I finish writing a book that when someone's reading it, they're not aware of me. Not until approaching Tokyo would he find those gifts, he being Sherlock Holmes, I should mention beforehand. Not until approaching Tokyo would Holmes find those gifts that he had... That's the other thing about reading. That's the other thing I should mention.
Right.
I stumble across words. It's not fluid for me.
Right.
I trip all over them, which makes for... That can make for a very distracting... It's true. Yeah. Not until approaching Tokyo would he... Upon arriving from his travels abroad, he entered his stone-built farmhouse on a summer's afternoon, leaving the luggage by the front door for his housekeeper to manage. He then retreated into the library where he sat quietly, glad to be surrounded by his books and the familiarity of home. For almost 2 months he'd been away, traveling by military train across India, by a Royal Navy ship to Australia, and then finally setting foot on the occupied occupied shores of post-war Japan. God damn it, I know how to write a book.